been issuing guidance and alerts, whether it's vulnerabilities that we see. We've been issuing a series of alerts on North Korean activity. But of course, we want to continue to ensure that there are consequences for religious behavior. My department is focused on the defense and ensuring that network defenders have what they need. But there are other tools that the government has to deter these activities, whether that's sanctions, criminal penalties, diplomatic engagement. There's a lot that the government is doing to try to enforce consequences on this type of irresponsibility. If you see the threat increasing, though, are you satisfied with the punitive measures that have been put in place against Russia?
Well, how it looked, I'll see later, but that's standing on an inch and a quarter and still going down.
The sanctions are pretty severe, and I also...
In terms of getting that depth, it's effortless.
VW admitted 2 years ago to installing devices in its diesel vehicles that falsely improved their emissions tests. Now it's moving on to electric cars, using Pearsonari Glinton.
Volkswagen's diesel scandal is one of the biggest consumer fraud cases in U.S. history. Just days after it was discovered that VW supposedly claimed diesel cars were anything but clean, it was an existential crisis for the company. Here's the then head of VW North America, Michael Horn.
Our company was dishonest with the EPA and the California Air Resources Board, and with all of you. And in my German words,
it's easy to be skeptical of Volkswagen because, you know, they've got some kind of checkered history over the last few years. Pretty much every major manufacturer is talking about making big investments and moving to electric, but show me.
And then it'll be for consumers to judge. Sonari Button, NPR News.
This is NPR News.
This is 90.9 WBUR. Coming up on Morning Edition, a preview of the first state dinner of the Trump administration. Tonight's dinner. Listeners have the opportunity to attend open meetings of WBUR's executive advisor.
People have the money and the people have the power.
Legal says democratic change must happen, and it's time for Ortega to realize that. Kerry Khan, NPR News, Manawa, Nicaragua.
Thank you both. If you want to get to know Maya Azumi, this year's winner, you can see video of him and the song you've been listening to at the NPR Music website, and you can hear an interview with him later today.
Support for NPR's Tiny Desk comes from the Lagunitas Brewing Company, proud supporters of the Tiny Desk Contest, and working to help bands.
He is believed to have struggled with mental illness. Public Safety Minister Ralph Goodale was in Toronto hosting other safety and security ministers of the G7. The loss of China's threat will remain unchanged based on available information that suggested the attack was an isolated incident. Toronto's police chief says the city has mobilized all available resources and its expected officers will be on the scene for several days for the investigation.
It's so hard not to hit the ground.
President Trump is facing
pressure. It's not really ideal.
A nuclear deal arranged with Iran. French President Macron.